Welcome to Module 26. Today our topic is discussion of union of spaces. To start with a set X which is written as disjoint union of sets. Okay. This is one special case that we are saying. Suppose each xi is given a topology tau I. Okay. Consider tau equal to all subsets of x such that A intersection xi is in tau I for every I. See, A being subset of the disjoint union, it is union of subsets from each xi, right? So those are the A intersection xi's. So all of them must be open in the corresponding xi. That is the meaning of A intersection xi is tau I. Take all such A, put them together in one single family. That tau is a topology on X. So this is called the disjoint topology. I start with the subsets here are all disjoint. Mutually disjoint, that is the meaning of this. Okay. This symbol, cup union, I am always using for disjoint union. Okay. Verification is obvious, I mean easy. Empty set belongs to this, union belongs to this, because each xi will belong to tau I. So x, if you take A equal to x, A intersection xi will be xi. So they are there. So if A1 and A2 are there, then A1 intersection xi, A2 intersection xi are there. So A1 intersection, A2 intersection xi will be there for each I. So intersection is there and so on. You can verify that. They are all straightforward verifications. What is important here is xi tau I becomes a subspace of x tau. Why? Because what is an open subset here? If something is open subset here, I can just take that open set, whatever it is, don't put anything from any other xi at all. Its intersection with xi will be the same set. Intersection with any other xj will be empty. Therefore, such a set is inside tau automatically. So each AI belonging to tau I is already inside tau. Okay. So xi tau I becomes a subspace of x tau. Because once AI is there, AI intersection xi will be just AI. All right. Not only that, each xi will be now open inside x. And therefore, it's also closed inside X because each XI is a complement of other XIs, XJs. Okay, so this is the easiest picture of when you take disjoint union. Okay, this is also interesting, but more interesting cases will be when things are not disjoint. Okay, that is where what you call as patching up topological spaces comes into picture. So I will not use the word patching up because patching up has different meanings at different people. Okay. So what I want to do is more interesting case is when union is not necessarily disjoint. Can we still put a topology of meaningfully? You can always put a topology indiscrete or discrete and so on. It has something to do with each subspace. If there is already a topology for each of these subsets. Okay, so let us go step by step. let us consider the following situation where x is union of xi. Now I have put a round cup here, so this is not necessarily disjoint. Now each xi, okay, x itself is a topological space. Suppose that is the case. Suppose each xi is given the subspace topology. X is topological space, these are subsets. So we know what is the meaning of subspace topology. Further, suppose that A contained inside X is open in X, if and only if A intersection Xi is open in Xi for each I. So this is an extra assumption I am making. Start with the topological space X, which is written as union of Xi, and give the subspace topology, and then assume this condition. Okay, it is not clear why this should be true at all. Okay, so this I have copied from whatever we did here. Okay, so that is why I am trying to put that condition here and see what happens. So with all these data, it is better to call it a name so that we don't have to keep on telling all these things every time. So in such a situation, we say X has the topology coherent with respect to the collection of subspaces Xi. So this is the definition of coherent. Coherent with the collection of subspaces means this much. Okay. Maybe later on we'll improve upon this definition and so on, but right now this is definition. It is easily checked that X has coherent topology with respect to Xi in the following cases, namely the first case when X itself was a disjoint union. We have actually copied that property of the disjoint union topology here, so there it is obvious. Okay, there is another easy example wherein each Xi is an open subset of X. So I recall, take X, Xi's are some subspaces, union the whole thing X. But now I am assuming each Xi is open inside X. Okay. Then what happens? Suppose A intersection Xi is open in Xi. Automatically it will be open in X also. That is what we have seen. So each A intersection Xi is open in X, their union will be A, so that's also open. So the condition, coherency, whatever we have there, I have verified it here. Okay, so these are two examples, easy examples of coherent topology. All right. Let us introduce another important concept here, okay, which is relevant in this context, appropriate in this context. And that will allow us to have more examples. Let A be any family of subsets of a topological space, okay, X. We say A is locally finite at a point X. It's like continuity definition. It's point-wise I am defining first, okay? Locally finite at a point. If there is a neighborhood U of X such that U intersects only finitely many members of A. Each point when you are given, the neighborhood you can choose. The neighborhood automatically depends upon the point. Okay, the number of members which intersect also depends upon the point as well as the neighborhood. Once there is a neighborhood, all smaller neighborhoods will also satisfy that. Okay, so that's why I can put just a neighborhood, then you can make it an open neighborhood also, because every neighborhood contains an open neighborhood. So there is no harm in putting neighborhood. Okay, if this happens at every point of X, then you call A locally finite. That's why I have indicated the similarity between definition of continuity. Continuity at a point, then continuity at all the points is continuous function. That is what we have defined for continuous functions, for example. So similar local finiteness at each point, and then local finiteness on the whole of x. So now I will give you an interesting example of coherent topology, the third example, you may say. Now suppose Xi is a locally finite collection of closed subspaces. So this is the extra condition, I'm assuming. X is equal to union of Xi, that is given already. So this is extra condition, okay? But now each time they are closed also. Each of them is closed also. Then local finiteness. So two extra conditions I've been assuming. Okay. Then I claim that X has the coherent topology with respect to Xi. Okay, so let us check this one. I have to check it point wise, right? That's what I have to do, right? I have to coherent topology, I have to prove A, if A is such that A intersection Xi is open in Xi, then I have to show that A is open in X. It's not point-wise. Point-wise is in the definition of local finite. Okay. So start with the subset X, subset A of X, such that A intersection Xi is open in Xi for each I. This just means that A intersection Xi is equal to Ui intersection Xi, where Ui is open in X. So this is the definition of subspace topology. The Xi's are subspaces of X. Okay, now given X belonging to A, okay, so now I have to do local. I should produce an open subset of X, such that X belongs to that open set, and that open set is contained inside A. That's what I have to do, right? So use the local finiteness and choose an open set U in X such that X is in U and U intersects only finitely many members of this family. You can just, for the while, you can just label them as X1, X2, Xn. All right. So this is a picture. This X is there. I have formed a U. This U intersects only finitely many of them. All other Xi's are far away. Out of which, look at X. Where does X belong to? Here X belongs to X1, also X2, but it does not belong to X3, X4, X5, other things. Okay, so that is important for me. So what I do, start with a open set U such that this intersects only finitely many. Among the stem, by relabeling, if you want, X1, X2, Xn in that, not in that order, you may assume that X is inside Xi, y equal to 1, 2, 3, up to k. And not in other Xi's for I bigger than k. If it happens that it is inside all of the Xi, it doesn't matter. It must be in one of them after all. Okay, because it's inside U, and U intersection union of all Xi's is U, out of which you have taken all those which intersect that one. So it must be inside one of three. Okay. So some of them will be there. This part is non-empty. This part may be empty, but doesn't matter. So now we put V equal to our U, whatever you have chosen, intersect with finitely many of these UIs. What are UIs? UIs are open subsets of X, such that Xi intersection Ui is the given open set. That is what Ai is.
Excuse me, sir. X also must belong to all this Ui for I 1, 2 up to K?
That follows.
Assume na?
That follows. No, that follows. You see, what is that? A intersection Xi. It's an element of A, first of all. If it is inside Ui also.
But X is not in Ui. X is in Xi only. But
no. X must be inside UI, the ones which are in UI, okay. If it's in XI and A, it will be in UI. This is equality here.
Yes.
So
yes,
whether you make it UI and XI or whichever way, it is the same thing.
Correct. Thank you.
Okay. So first of all, it must be there. This X1, X2, XK, K is at least greater than or equal to 1. That's important. Otherwise, this will be empty. You will not get any neighborhood. Okay, U intersection, I into 1 to K, UI, and throw away all these XIs, K plus 1 to N. Throw away means what? You are taking complement. Complements are open subsets because each XI is open. Okay. Each XI is closed subset. Okay. So union is a closed subset. The complement is also open subset, that is why you are intersecting with that, which is the same thing as that V is an open subset now. Since X is not here, and X is here, X is here, X will be inside V, and V is contained inside A now, because what is A? A is a union of A intersects all these X1, X2, it's contained inside X1, X2, Xn itself, and it doesn't intersect this part, so it will be inside this one. So this V will be inside A. So it is true for every X inside A, so A is open. A typical way coherent topology is used is the following, namely patching up continuous functions which you have been using in analysis. In one variable calculus, you usually use the other one. Namely, a continuous function is given in first closed interval and in the second closed interval, the two closed intervals intersect only at one point. There, the function is just defined, that's all. But then automatically, it will be continuous on the whole thing. Only the function should be defined properly, means in the intersection, the value should be the same. So there, you are taking finite intersections of closed sets. But usually, if you have an arbitrary union of open sets, then this is possible. This will be used only when you go to R2, R3, and Rn, and so on. I am talking about in analysis. Okay. In one variable analysis, you don't meet this one quite often. At XPA topological space, X is union of XIs, and the topology on X is coherent with the family of subspaces of XI. Now, I am not making any assumption whether XIs are open or closed and so on. Those three examples were there, disjointness, openness, or closedness with local finiteness. Under these three, we know it's coherent. But suppose any family is coherent like this, has coherent topology and so on, then given any function X to Y, set theory function, okay? And Y is any topological space. F is continuous if and only restricted to each XI is continuous. It's one line proof. How do you prove our definition of continuity? Take an open subset of Y, say U, F inverse of U must be open inside X. How do you prove X is open? Use coherent topology. Intersect with each XI, you show that it is open. What is the intersection of F inverse of U with XI? It is nothing but F restricted to XI, take the function, take inverse of that of U. So suppose you call this as FI. Then FI inverse of U is nothing but F inverse of U intersect with XI. Because FI is nothing but F itself but restricted to XI. Okay, so you have coherence topology has a property that something is open if and only if intersection with each XI is open in XI. Thus, coherent topology provides a method of constructing continuous functions on the whole space from continuous functions given on each piece. Okay, so this is what you have to remember. The actually three cases we have now, I said both cases, because disjoint union was introduced as a motivating example. Okay, so both cases discussed in the previous remark are instances where the above theorem is applied in constructing continuous functions. Even you can include disjointness also, that's obvious anyway. Nobody mentions that one, but that is the starting point of all this discussion. Now let us move to somewhat more general situation. Let X be a set which is written as union of subsets. How many? I don't know. Whether they're closed, no. Open, I don't know. Just union of Xi. But each Xi has a topology tau I. Now you see what I have done. Coherent topology, I start the topology on X. Here, I am just given topology on each Xi. That's all. Okay. Can we put a topology on X which is coherent with the collection Xi tau I? Remember, I repeat this one. What is the meaning of topology? You must have a topology on X. Then the given topology is tau I must be subspaces. After that, that coherent condition is there. One more, namely, something is open in tau if and only intersection with each Xi is open in X, open in Xi. So all this can we do? There is no topology given on tau, given on X. Can we find such a tau is the question. Okay, so this is a fundamental question, but it doesn't seem to have an if and only if answers. Okay. But that is lucky. Actually, it will give you, we can have theorems wherein there will be useful theorems. Suppose this happens, then this is true. Suppose it happens, then that kind of theorems are more useful than if and only if theorems quite often. So can we put this? So we would like to have at least some partial solution of this problem, if not full one. Okay. Here is one such. There are two conditions here actually. So I've clubbed them together. So don't get afraid because it's going to be too much. Okay, so let us go through slowly. Most of the things are repeated here. X is union of Xi. Each Xi is a topology. Okay, so that much is underlying hypothesis. Now assume that the following compatibility conditions are satisfied. There are two conditions here. Each of them has two of them. Okay, in the brackets there are another set of conditions. That's like that. So for each pair ij, Xi intersection xj is open. This one condition. This openness you replace by close. That is another set of conditions. So you can call it as CC1 and CC1 prime if you like. Okay. Each pair ij, Xi intersection xj is open in both Xi and xj. So this is the first condition. The second condition is, for each pair ij, the two topologies on Xi intersection xj induced from Xi tau I and xj tau j must be the same. These two, there are two topologies, they are the same. Okay, see Xi intersection Xj is subspace of Xi. It's all subspace of Xj. Okay, both of them, if there is a topology on X, they would be subspace of the same X. Then by the transitivity condition we have proved, automatically this would have been the same. I want to put a topology on X, then this condition is a must. So that is why I have put this condition. You understand? Because of the transitivity of subspace topology, on the intersection, you can come from Xj or Xi, two different ways. They must be the same. Okay, right now, there is no topology on Xi. I don't have that one. But if I want to put it, this is a must. So better start with this condition. Of course, this condition may not guarantee. So I have some more conditions also here, first one. Okay. So the conclusion is now there exists a unique topology tau on X, which is coherent with the collection Xi tau I. So answer is positive. So it is characterized by the property that each Xi is open inside X, or in the other part, when you have taken closing, it will be closed subspace of X. So as I have told you, the condition CC2 is a must. But this one is not a must. We don't want everything to be open or closed or something. We just want them to be, you know, subspaces and coherent topologies, all that I want. Xi are subspaces. You want them to be subspaces of a common topological space. In the very first case, what was that? Disjoint union. We had such a thing, right? So the other two cases I am taking, if all of them are such that intersections are open in both of them, or intersections are closed in both of them, then it is possible. So this is the next case that we have. Okay. The proof is very easy. The only statement is long. All that I do is exactly same way I defined for the disjoint union, I'm going to define tau. Tau is all A contained inside X, such that intersection with each Xi is inside tau I. All right. When you verified that tau is a topology when the case is they are disjoint, that disjointness was never used for the verification. It is just the phenomena that if A is written as union of intersections, then it is the same thing as intersections of the unions and so on. That's what you have to verify. Okay. So this is topology is no problem. The above definition of tau is forced on us by the condition of coherence, because if something is open here, A intersection Xi, okay, must be inside tau I for every I. That is a coherency. Okay. So I have to put that, and I have put that much only. That is enough. That's the point. Okay. Therefore, the uniqueness follows. The tau must be like this if it is coherence. Okay, what is required here is that verification of tau is a topology, which I have already done. Whatever condition verification, condition is forced on us, we have put just that much. That gives you coherence automatically. But why topology? That comes much more easily. That's a general phenomena. Okay, so sometimes easy proofs will stun you. So better spend a little more and half a minute more on that, so that we are not making any obvious mistakes. Okay, so you have this one. There is two other things which you have to prove. Suppose each Xi is such that Xi intersection Xj is open inside both Xi and Xj. Then I have to show that Xi itself is open. Similarly for close. But that is very easy again, because you fix I. I want to show that Xi is open. Right? What is the coherency condition? Intersection with each Xj must be open in Xj. J equal to I also allowed. Xi intersection Xi is Xi itself that is open. Xi intersection Xj is open in Xj is the condition given in CC1. That's all. Similarly, open you replace by closeness, that will give you CC1, the close for the closeness. Okay. So finally, one more thing you have to check. Why the topology, original topology tau I, is the subspace topology? The definition of subspace topology is what? A subset is open if and only if it can be written as intersection with some open set in X with respect to Xi. Okay. So how do you check this one? Look at the definition of tau itself. Okay. So what is tau? Take any member of tau, A intersection Xi is inside Xi is the condition. So when you restrict it, it's already contained inside tau i. They are elements of tau i. You have to show that there are no more elements in tau i. Right? So take an open set inside tau i. That means something belongs to tau i. Then I must show that it is A intersection, you know, something where this A is coming from A is an open subset of X. So right. So that is the Connors part. Suppose A containing Xi is open in Xi. In the first case, you have to do two different cases separately. In the first case, we have shown that Xi is open. A is open in Xi, Xi is open in X, so A is open in Xi. Okay, so what? So it follows that each tau I is contained inside tau restricted to Xi and conversely. Okay, in the second case, Xi is closed in X. Right? Take De Morgan law, use complement. Xi minus A is closed in Xi because I started with A open inside Xi. So Xi minus A is closed in Xi, and Xi is closed in X, so this is closed in X. Therefore, its complement X minus Xi minus A, right, is open in X. But what is this set? You have to see that this set is precisely A is equal to Xi intersection with this one. This is a closed subset, this is open subset now. Intersection with this one will be precisely this one, Xi intersection A, X minus Xi minus A. Okay, this is purely set theory thing. A is a subset of Xi started, so it is contained in Xi. And it is contained inside this X minus A. You are throwing away A and then throwing away Xi itself, Xi minus A itself, so A will come back. Okay, only A will remain, only A will remain is the point. So this intersection is precisely equal to A. If this is the case, A belongs to tau of X, tau restricted to X. Okay, so that proves the coherency of this topology completely. There are three conditions we have to verify. What were there? That each Xi, tau I is the subspace topology, right? First of all, tau is a topology restricted to each Xi. It gives you the original topology tau i's. Okay, and then depending upon closeness and openness, you have to show that each Xi is open or each Xi is closed. Two different cases. So here is an example. One of the useful examples in this situation is when X is a disjoint union itself. Okay, then the necessary condition CC1 and CC2 are all automatically satisfied. So we have tau, the coherent topology with respect to tau I. In particular, each Xi is both open and closed. Okay, so I have already indicated, I am just repeating this. Here is a case wherein each Xi is both open and closed will come, because intersections are all empty, which are both open and closed. Okay, so let us stop here today.